Hello creators, my name is Anne and I'm here to show you how to easily make ruffles in Cloth3D and Marvelous Designer. Today we will make these two types, single edge and double edge ruffles. I will show you what tools to use, how to achieve flawless simulation and realistic look in detailed gathering. I will add ruffles to this skirt. If you want to practice with me, download this project file. I'll left a link in the description. And let's get started! These are the most popular types of ruffles. Basically, it's a wide strip of fabric gathered at the top edge. Very simple construction. Let's add it to the skirt. So first thing first, draw a line to which we'll sew the ruffle. Select top edges, right click, offset as internal line. I will type distance 8 cm and check extent so the lines touch outlines. Press OK or enter on a keyboard. Here we go. The front and back of the skirt are equal, so I'll make a ruffle only for the front and then duplicate it to the back. Select the line and you will see the length. 22.5 cm. It's one half of the line, because this pattern has symmetric editing. Let's make the ruffle symmetric as well, create half of the ruffle and then unfold it. Press S, rectangle tool, and left click in a 2D window. We should make a rectangular pattern longer than 22.5 cm to form a gathering on the top edge. I will double the length so it will be 45 cm. The height 10 cm, or wherever you like. Now let's unfold it. Click on the right edge, right click, unfold symmetric editing with sewing. Now let's sew it to the skirt with N segment sewing tool. Usually we place new patterns with right click superimpose site for this case, but it doesn't work great with ruffles, so it's better to place them manually. I press Ctrl F to reset the pattern arrangement. Then move the pattern up and place it in front of the skirt. Now you can simulate. If the ruffle collides with arms or with the skirt, you can place it on the arrangement points. Shift F and place it on one of these central points. Then go to the Property Editor, find Arrangement Settings, closer to the end, and increase the offset value. These arrangement settings often come in handy, especially the offset. Then freeze the skirt, Ctrl K, so it doesn't move during the simulation. Especially if you attach it to a long or puffy skirt and simulate on CPU. Then simulate. Oh, this ruffle decided to collide with the skirt. That's why I like to set a sublayer to create a layer dependency between patterns. Select this tool here, click on the ruffle first, then on the skirt. Simulate, and the problem solved. Now the ruffle will always be on top of the skirt. Then decrease particle distance to make it more detailed. Let's make it 10 and see how it looks. That's not enough, so one more time to 5. Simulate. It looks pretty good for now. If you feel like there is too much or too little amount of fabric and folds, make the ruffle longer or shorter. Grab the side edge and press Shift to move it only horizontally, vertically or diagonally. I want to make it shorter a bit, so I move it horizontally to the left. Right-click while holding the left mouse button and type the distance moved. I will make it shorter by 7 cm. Press OK and simulate. The gathering will be recalculated automatically. By the way, let's simulate on GPU if you have it. It's much quicker than CPU. Change it here by clicking and holding the simulation button. It doesn't work great for a final simulation when you have a lot of layers, facings, linings, but works pretty well with ruffles. Now copy this ruffle to the back of the skirt, Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V and paste it. Select the ruffle in a 3D window and press Ctrl-G to flip horizontally and place it on the back, closer to the internal line. If you don't see your internal line, go here and turn on Show Internal Lines. You can switch between camera views, 8 for back view, 4 and 6 for side views, and place the ruffle. Then sew it to the skirt and sew the side seams as well. Simulate and add a sublayer. Unfreeze the skirt and simulate again. You can notice that the ruffle stretches the seam line a bit. Sometimes it's not so visible, like in my case, when the sewing line is uneven. But sometimes you can sew the ruffle to the even line, like here. In both cases, you can fix it. Select the lines and turn on the elastic option in the Property Editor. Then change the ratio to 100, so the length of the elastic will be the same as the line itself, 22.5 cm. I found this method the most effective to stabilize the line and keep the length. Finally, I want to make the gathering more detailed, so I need to decrease particle distance for it one more time. But I don't want to touch the rest of the pattern, the bottom edge. It is detailed enough. For this, we can subdivide selected areas. There is a Select Brush tool in the 3D toolbar. If you click and hold on it, you will see additional tools, Box and Lasso. Box is one that we need. Now select a few top centimeters of the ruffle. Maybe a little bit more. Right-click. Oh, it doesn't work in a 2D window. So select and right-click on it in a 3D window. Subdivide. I remember that I could subdivide it with a brush selection tool, so it may be a bug with Box. Do the same with the back ruffle. Select, subdivide and simulate. You can see that now the polygons are smaller in the selected area and the gathering is more detailed. It's also highlighted with the color. You can see it if you are in the texture surface mode. You can select and delete these subdivided areas. You can also hide the color. Right-click somewhere in a 3D window, show hide color, hide subdivide mesh. And that's it. The first ruffle is done. Now let's make this ruffle with an additional piece at the top edge. But first, I want to say thank you for all your likes and comments. I really appreciate it. Moreover, it helps other creators to find this video on YouTube. If you have some problems or wishes, feel free to leave comments below and press the bell, you will get a notification as soon as I release a new video. So let's make the second ruffle. It's actually similar to the first one, but with an additional piece on top. So copy and paste the first ruffle. Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V and paste it. Only the front part. Now let's draw new internal lines. Select the first ones, right-click, offset internal lines and type a distance. I'll type about 17 cm. The length is 25.8 cm. This time I want to make a ruffle about 44 cm. Make as wide as you like. If you press Shift Z, you will see the lengths of each line including our ruffle. It's 38 cm at the moment, so I need to extend it by 6. Then sew it to the skirt. Place it on arrangement points as we did it for the previous ruffle. Freeze the skirt. And simulate. You can increase the particle distance for the ruffle if your computer is struggling. GPU works pretty fast, unlike CPU, so I don't need to increase it. Then add a top ruffle. It has the same width as the main part, so copy and paste it. And shorten it to about 2 cm. Grab the bottom edge and move it up. Right click, shorten by 8 cm. Then sew the bottom edge to the top edge of the main part. And place it a little bit closer in a 3D window. Simulate and set a sublayer. It sticks out at the moment, but I want it to be parallel to the skirt, more vertical. There are a few tricks. The first one, change the physical properties of the fabric. I have the basic fabric, which comes when you add a new material, default 5.2. Each material has different physical properties and you can adjust them here. The one we need is a bending warp. I will turn on the simulation to show you the difference. If you increase this value, the ruffle goes up. If you decrease it, it goes down. I think somewhere around 55-60 looks good. It makes sense to increase it only for the top ruffle and leave the default fabric for the rest of the skirt. So I will add a new material and apply it for the rest of the patterns. Here we go. The second trick is to change the fold angle for this seam. Press B, Edit Sewing Tool and select the sewing line. Here is a fold angle settings. Unfortunately, the difference won't be visible on GPU simulation. So let's switch to the CPU. Oh my god, how slow it is. I will freeze the first ruffle and the back of the skirt to make it at least a little bit quicker. Now select the sewing line. By default, the fabric pieces are stitched at a 180 degree angle, but we can adjust it. When we sew a garment in real life, we can press at the seams or make some folds with an iron. Here we can make a similar effect with the fold angle setting. If we decrease this value, the ruffle will start to straighten up. This is how it looks with zero fold angle. Adjust these settings depending on your wishes. I like to make it not so straight, so I set it to 90 or 120. Now let's finish this ruffle. Duplicate it to the back. Ctrl-G, place it and sew it, as we did earlier for the first ruffle. I turn on GPU again. We need to apply a subdivision again because it hasn't been transferred when we copied the ruffle. Select Mesh Box tool and subdivide. This top ruffle has a big particle distance, so I will decrease it as well. 3 or maybe 2 is good. Simulate. Congratulations, we made ruffles, and it's time to say goodbye. Thank you for your feedback and comments. I really appreciate it. See you in the next videos. Bye!